That sign says that all. We're in the Herculaneum. This is the excavation site for the ancient Roman city of Herculaneum that was covered up by the Vesuvius. It's the Bay of Naples out there. Mount Vesuvius, and this is Herculaneum right here. That's the boathouses and stuff down there. Statue that we photographed earlier. And then you have modern Herculaneum sits above it. That's why they can't excavate the whole city, is because the current city of Herculano sits on top of it. Have a nice buffet. Okay. This is the interior of the hotel in Vitelli. This is the bar. They don't have it lit up right now. Maybe I ought to photograph it tonight. But someone spared no expense in building this place. Oh, it even has a grand staircase. Get over here. I think it has four baby grand pianos on it. Reminds me a lot of Jurassic Park. Look at this clock. This is the lobby. Check this out. Ceiling. Front desk. In here. One of the things that's wrong is that they play rock music and it does not go out of big court. I'm going to put myself in the video and just there I am. It's nice though. It's just, I just can't get over these chandeliers and stuff. They're really nice. Thank you. have the sculpture of the Greek wrestlers. You step up here, look what they've got. They've got these. Look at their statues. The lamps. It's really quite amazing. Then they have the pool deck over here. Statues in front of this pool. Beautiful. This is right out of the turn of the century decor. The Royal Palace at Caserta, built by the Bourbon Kings. See, he's got some wings and stuff over here. This is the largest palace in Italy. You can see the gardens back there. We're walking through the gardens of the Royal Palace at Caserta. I couldn't shoot much on the inside. I got snag shooting photos, so those are no here. But I'm by the book. Thank you. those points where you have multiple entrances. And exits. This must be the children's duck pond. There's the pond. There's the ducks. Looking back, we have some stray dogs taking a rest out here. Sit down here in the shade, cooling down before we get in the sun. Make that big walk up there to that big mountain. Plastic pumps aren't over there making all the noise. Oh, they just turned it off. How convenient. Then I'll come back and get that waterfall again. Here, now you can hear it. Even has pitch. We're taking a rest off of the main path, but if you listen closely, other than hearing dogs barking, you can hear cicadas in the trees. Little people know this, but I think the Italians invented the infinity pool because these are different terraces. Looking all the way back to the oil palace back there. Thank you. one's about 2 miles. Stopping here in the gardens at the Royal Palace of Caserta and taking a little break here, having some Gatorade. We're now in the English garden section of the Royal Palace. There's a nice rose garden over there. Royal Palace of Caserta. It's dedicated. Checking out the trees and hedges and stuff. Poplars, umbrella pines, and this shop. Still in the English garden. There's some people out there relaxing somewhere. Like European royalty, you ain't nobody unless you got a nice fake ruin on your property. And this is a fake ruin. Right here in the middle of this pond. Monet would be happy here. Look at the water lilies. Way out here in the woods. We're walking back to the palace. From all the way up there. I can't see in the viewfinder because of the fact that it's too bright out. We're getting there. It's been a long day. That's a huge palace. You can see by that. Compare the size of the people to the size of the entrance. Was our room here at the hotel out there called Benvitelli. Has a little sitting area out here. Betty's taking off her socks because we just spent 6 full hours on the grounds of the Royal Palace of Caserta. And that's got a nice bathroom. A beaded, I mean, today.